everybody, so I'm back with another scraps video. Now I said last week that I was going to do heart-shaped cards this week. However, when I was looking at paper scraps to go with the heart kind of shape and theme, I didn't really have anything that worked with it. So what I'm going to do instead is I found this old kit here. It's a Pebbles Ink one, Happy Cake Day. And I remember being sent this long time ago to do a commission for a magazine, and I've never really touched it since. You've got puffy stickers, I've got tons of toppers here, but there's also a sausage dog. And if you don't know, I have a sausage dog called Monty, so I just thought I need to use these papers. So what I thought I would do is I'm just going to make fun fold cards. So this is actually a scrap as well, because you can see where I've cut that off, and then that one, and then these three are the full sheets. So I'm going to leave those, but with all of this, I'm going to see how many fun fold cards I can make. So let's get started. So for card number one, I'm going to do a pinwheel card. So this will be 5x7 in size. Follow the measurements that come up on the screen and the ones that I say, not the ones that you can physically see here, because I started scoring and then I changed it. But you're not going to see these score lines anyway, so it doesn't matter. You want one piece of 6x7, and along the 6-inch side, you're going to score at 1/2 inch, 1.5, 2.5, and 3.5. You'll then want three pieces of 2.5x7. And then on these three, and on the large panel on the, well, for me, it's on that right hand side, you'll have a 1/2 inch one on the left. These here are all 2¼ by 6¾. So stick those all down, and then fold and burnish those score lines. So you will have something that will wrap around like this. So you just want to run some glue or double-sided tape along that 1/2 inch tab. And if you fold down the 1-inch piece and the 1/2 inch piece, and then fold that one over. And then when you bring it up, you'll have a perfect square in the middle, and that will stand up. You're then going to stick these on each side of here. So one there, I'm going to have the sausage dog, then the stripe, sausage dog, and then the stripe. So you just, very easy, just want to add your glue all down here. And each time you stick it down, just kind of just push it down onto your desk, and that way you know these are all flush with the bottom of the card and it's not going to rock. So just repeat that on the other two sides. Now you'll see you've got that pinwheel design on the top there, and then it will fold flat and that will fit into a 5x7 envelope. Now I'm going to decorate these as well, but I want to wait till I've done the other cards and then see what scraps I've got left. If I haven't got any scraps left, then I'm just going to emboss some panels down there. But the size you'll need to cover those will be 1¼ by 6¾. So I'm going to leave mine like this for now. I'm going to do all of the sentiments and all of the further decoration at the end. So for card number two, I'm going to do a never-ending card. I haven't made one for a good few years now. I do have, in fact, all the cards that I'll be doing, I already have on the channel, but they're either very old tutorials or maybe a different size that I've done. This one is very easy, but it's a really fun card. I'm kind of getting a bit of a kid's theme with all of these cards that I'm putting together. So you want four pieces of 3x6, and this will make a 6x6 size card. So four pieces of that size, and along the 6-inch side, you're going to score at 1½ and 4½. Flip and do 1½ and 4½ again, because these are going to fold in both directions. Do that on all of the pieces and then fold and burnish in both directions. Okay, now you can use liquid glue if you want, but you don't really want the glue going anywhere apart from each corner. So you're just going to take two of these pieces and sit them side by side. Make sure the score lines line up perfectly. You might have to turn them around. There we go, that lines up better. And then what you might find useful is just coming in and marking halfway, which would be 1½. I'm just going to put a pencil mark there at 1½. Just come in here, it'd be 4½. And again, along the bottom, you can rub this pencil out again if you see it. And then you just want to add your tape. Just use that pencil line now as a as a guide, and you're just going to now add tape in that 1.5 squared area. So you can use liquid glue, but you don't want the liquid glue going over into this area here. And then do the same. So you can see there exactly what I've done. Just make sure you stay within that 1.5 square. Now I'll start with one corner first. I'm just going to take the backing off here. So with these two here, you've got your lines horizontal. These ones, you want them to be vertical. Okay. I'm going to take this one and I'm going to stick it over here. Ignore that one for a minute. You just want to line this up so you've got a perfect right angle. And just make sure that runs nice and parallel with both sides there. And then take the backing off of this corner. And now you're going to do the same with this one. So just focus on the corner. If it catches on the inside, we can trim it. So don't worry about that at the moment. Just focus on getting these corners perfectly lined up. There we go. And then take away the backing on these ones. You can do this all at the same time now. And then take this one. And again, focus on the outer corners, because you want that to be nice and neat. We can sort everything else out. So now just turn it over. Now they fit perfectly side by side. They are going to work really well. But on this side, this one's overlapping slightly. So I'm just going to open it up and just take a slither off each time until they sit flush with each other nearly. And then I'm going to just take it off the other one. I think that's better. There we go. What you want this to now do, because it will now work how it's meant to, is as you turn each one, you don't want them catching. I'm just going to take a little bit off of that other side. Even though it was perfect, I think it can just do with having a little slither taken off. Okay, and now just test as you fold each side round and it all flips over, which it does, like so. And now you've got your never ending card. It's such a cool style. Like I said, kids love this. You'll kind of feel when you're back to the beginning again, and you can display it like so. It's a really, really clever style. Okay, so I've just gone ahead and stuck everything down because I wanted to make sure that I give you the right sizes and quantities. However, it may still vary because you may want to change it up a little bit, and I'll explain that in a moment. But I'm going to give you the sizes for the three size panels that this card creates, but you might want to change it a little bit. So these panels here, these rectangle ones, the matte layers for these are 2¾ by 1¼. The big squares, they're 2¾ squared. And then as you turn it, you've got these four little squares in the corner here. So these are 1¼ squared. And then as you turn this, these are actually the full squares again. But as you turn it, you might want these to be separate panels. So if you want to do like I have here, then these again are 1¼ by 2¾, or you may have just 1 2¾ squared matte layer. So I think that's all of the sizes. And then, like I said, the quantities, you know, it's going to vary, but it's about 8, I think, 4 of the little squares and then 8 of the big squares, 8 of the rectangles. But you can see how fun this looks. Like I said, mine's going to display like that. So I'm going to have maybe like that would be where you'd maybe write your message. And then with all of these, you know, squares, when I go to decorate it, there's so many fun elements that I can add to this. For card number 3, I'm going to do a side pillar card. I did this, I'm sure, in a 5x7 size for Easter. Again, if I remember, I will link the tutorial up there. So I'm going to do a 6x6 size today. So you'll want a piece of 10x6 and a piece of 4x6.5. Along this piece first, you're going to score at 1, 2, 3, and 4. And along the long side of this piece, you're going to score at 1/2 inch and 1.5. Fold and burnish all those score lines. Okay, so with this one, you've got your 4 1-inch panels here. On the very outer one here, just take a little little smidge off, just a little slither there, okay? And then if you add your glue, and then if you fold over, so you've got two on the front and two underneath, and then fold this 6x6 piece right the way over. Okay, and when you open it up, you've got a very similar start to the pinwheel card here. Okay, so now we want to decorate all of this first before this sticks on the top, like so. And then when it all folds down, that will go under, like so, and it will all fit into your 6x6 envelope. So I've got this piece here, which is 4¾ by 6¾, and that's going to cover that perfectly. Trim that down. So this will be, well, you'll want 1, 2, 3 pieces that are 3¼ by 5¾. Yeah, so that's going to work. So that's going to pop nicely against there. And then on the sides, I'm going to have, I think, this stripe. Okay, so those are all in place. And then probably easiest if you stick this side first. So just run a little glue just down there. Just cover about 3/4 of an inch. You could have this higher up if you want. You could have it thinner. It doesn't have to be 4 inches wide. Keep the length to what I gave you, but in terms of its width, you can change that. I'm going to have this so it's just about in the middle. You can do separate little squares. I think on maybe the Easter one, I've done little square mats there, but the whole strip's going to be fine on this one. And you just want to butt it right up to the edge here. Just make sure that's in the middle. And I'm going to fold that back just so I can push that down a bit better. I'm just going to open this up. And again, just run my glue down that 1/2 inch tab. And then fold, bring it up like this. Fold that all under, okay? And then fold it flat this way. And you'll see that 6x6 size that go in your envelope. So I've just covered those front panels. So you want a piece of 4¾ by 3¾. And then this one is 3/4 by 3¾ again. So you can see how that looks. And then on the back, if you cut a piece of 5¾ squared in white, and then you've got your place to write your message. But it should all stand up really nicely. Again, I'm going to decorate that further in a moment. Okay, for card number 4, I'm going to do the trifold shutter card. Again, I made this in a 5x7 at Christmas time, so I'm going to do a 6x6 today. I've got a template for the 5x7 that's on that tutorial again. It will be linked up here. I've just done a quick template for you for this one. So you want a piece of 12x6, okay, along the long side here. I'll keep that one there. You want to score at 4, just down 1 inch. Okay, so just with your stylus, just down like so, and then at 7, just down to 1 inch. And then if you flip the card, and again, 4, just use this. You can run a ruler along there if you need that to line up, but you can join this all together in a minute, so don't worry if you're a little bit out. And 7. Okay, I just went to do this one, but I think it's going to be easier to do this next one. So you want to then score at 6, but you want to start 1 inch down. And then just go down to 5 inches, so you're 1 inch up, okay? And then you're going to do that same score line, but at 9 inches. So again, I'm going to come down, so I'm roughly starting. It's best to always come under and then down. So you can see I've just created this score line here, and then this one at 9. Then if you pop this piece like so, from the bottom of this one here, which will be on your 5 inch marker, it should join up, and you want to go all the way down to that 9 inch score line. And then you can go back and just make sure that these connect then right down to that line. So I've just made this score line here from that 4 down to the top of the 9. But all these should meet and connect along there. And again, on this side, you can kind of hover your stylus and then just bring that all the way down. And then again, I can just join up those score lines. All the black are score lines. The pink here are score and cut lines. So we're now going to cut from the 4 down to the 9 on both of them. Now use your trimmer if you would prefer. I'm going to just use my cutting knife and ruler here. So you just want to sit that over or just up to the score line and then cut all the way down. And then again, like so. So the 4-inch score lines here, you want them to become mounting folds, along with this 6-inch score line, that also needs to become a mounting fold. And then these 7-inch and the 9 will all be valley folds. And you'll see when it all folds under, it will give you your 6x6 card size. Give all those score lines a good burnish, just flip it over, just kind of remove that bounce. There we go. Now you could have it open this way if you wanted to. You could even flip it over and it could open like this. I'm going to keep it like so. I'm going to cover this now with all the mats and layers, and then I'll give you the measurements after. Okay, so I've stuck everything down. I've had to change it a little bit because I didn't have the width of that stripe left. I've just got a thin one there, or it's too short, like these pieces. So I still think that works. Also, you can change the way that you have your mats laid out. So you'll see here I've got a smaller one, but you could do a longer one there. So if I give you the widths, so this one is well, you'd actually want it to really to be 2¾, because that's 3 inches. So 2¾ by 3¾ for that. But if you want to do it the whole height of the card, then it would be 5¾. Again, the same with this one. This could be a panel that comes right down here rather than across the middle part. So if you want the panel down there, then it would be 3¾ by 5¾. But I've got this one, which is 5¾ by 3¾. These here are all 3/4 wide. And then these are 3¾. This one is 2¾. And this one is 4¾. And then this one here, I think, is the same as that one. So yeah, 2¾ by 3¾. Again, I'll have all those measurements coming up. But you'll see now when it folds down, we've got the 6x6 card size there. It's a really, really fun style. And like I said, you can change it. So you could have it fold that way as well. You get that style there. So again, I'll decorate the rest of that in a moment. So for card number 5, and this is going to be the last one, I'm going to revisit the floating double panel card. Again, I made that originally in a 5x7 size, so this is 6x6. I've got my 6x6 card blank. This card, in case anybody's wondering, is the Lidl blue cardstock. I've got so much of it, I've just used it for every single card blank. So 6x6 card blank, and then you're going to have to forgive me, I've cheated a little bit. I've cut into that big pizza piece, that 12x12 piece, because I needed a mat layer that was big enough, because none of the scraps, I'll show you what I've got left in a moment. So that's 5¾, that's going to go on top. And then for the double panels, you want a piece of 6x4 and a piece of 6x2. And then on the back, you'll see I've got these springs, and I need one more for this corner here. So I've got 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 all together. And these are 4x1 inch. Along the 4-inch side, you're going to score at 1/2, 1, and 1½, and then 2½, 3, and 3½. The way I fold this is how you fold all the others. So you're going to do a mountain fold, valley fold, and a mountain fold. So you've got an M shape. And then again, on this side, it'll be a mountain, valley, mountain. So you see, we've got this little spring. If you add your glue to the 2½-inch tabs here, and then you want to stick on the big panel here, one in each corner and one in the middle, just to balance it out. And just push that down. I didn't burnish any of these. If you burnish them, you won't get so much of a spring. So I've just folded them, and that's it. So now I've got that one. So I'm going to stick this one down on here. Then this one will go on top. And you'll see it will go flat to go in an envelope, but it will pop up. And they look like they're floating. To mat that one, I've got this piece here. And this is 3¾ by 5¾. Then I've popped 3 springs on that one. And that's going to stick on top of here. And then I've got this piece, which is 1¾ by 5¾. That's going to go on the top. And again, it's going to look nice when I put my sentiment and everything on there. I'm going to stick all that down. So I've got the 5 cards all ready now for me to just finish with my decoration. And then those are all of the scraps now. And that was the one that I had to do the mat layer for. And then I've just got those ones that I showed you at the beginning left still. So I will keep all of this and I will use it again in a few weeks time for another scraps video. But now I'm going to use these bits here and the puffy stickers as well and decorate all of this. So that's all of the cards finished. I'll go back through them all again and let me know which ones are your favourite. So number one was the pinwheel card. So I've just added the yay you, got a little cake and hat there. And I've also added the yellow there because I had enough of that left to cover the sides there. It's a really fun style. Number two was the never ending card. So I've added these images on the front and then on the inside. And then I've left these blank. I might personalize it with maybe a birthday number if I know who I'm going to give that to. And then number three was the side panel card. So I've just added the sentiment there, have a lovely birthday, with the balloons. And then this is the shutter card. So I've added the hot dog image there, it's your birthday, and I thought that tied together quite nicely. And then number five, which is probably my favourite, I think. I don't know actually this time. I kind of like them all. Maybe that one as well. But you can see all that dimension there. Really fun, love this style. I might end up adding a few my little embellishment sequins, things like that, just to add a little bit of sparkle. But for now, really pleased with these ones. So those are five fun fold cards using your scraps. So I have the other scraps videos. I have some playlists coming up, videos here. Click on those if you want to go and get some more inspiration and watch those next. I will try and link the product. I'm not sure if this one's still available. It's really old, so you might be somewhere like, so you might have to look on like eBay, somewhere like that. If you've enjoyed today, please give me a thumbs up. It really does help out the channel, and consider subscribing if you haven't done so already, and make sure you click the notification bell, and that way you won't miss out on any future videos. Take care, and I'll see you all again soon. Bye.